The New Zealand Initiative has been critical of our approach to teaching maths for many years. Oliver Hartwich is Executive Director of the New Zealand Initiative with us now. Hi, Oliver.
Hi, Heather. How are you?
What do you have issue with in terms of the way that maths is taught?
Well, we've been concerned for a very long time about the performance of our students in maths. And in fact, it's been documented well in the PISA study the OECD does every few years. So basically, since the early 2000s, we have lost so much in maths that today's 15-year-olds only perform as 13.5-year-olds would have performed at the beginning of the century. So there's reason for concern, and we've been pointing this out for many years. We think the teaching and the assessment of mathematics has gone wrong, and it's just a symptom of a wider failure in the education system.
And so what is it that has gone wrong in terms of the teaching? Is it an abandonment of the basic stuff like the times tables?
Yes, that is part of it. I mean, first of all, we are not properly monitoring what's going on in our schools. It takes international studies like PISA to tell us that something is going wrong because we don't have any national equivalents. We are not regularly checking, monitoring the performance of our students in our education system. We need international assessments like PISA, like TIMSS, like PIRLS to do that for us. But actually, we should be doing this ourselves. So something is wrong in the assessment and monitoring. There's also something wrong in the curriculum because we're not prescribing a knowledge-rich curriculum. We're actually often leaving it to schools. And then, of course, on top of all of that, we have a child-centered approach when it comes to education, which sounds very positive and nice. The problem is actually it doesn't work because actually we should be prescribing what children should learn rather than leaving it to the creativity of students and pupils to tell us what they would like to do today. So actually it's times tables because we need to get the basics right. We need to really store the basics deep down in the brain so that the students can then move on towards the more interesting, more creative kind of stuff. In fact, what we're doing in our schools at the moment is we're having it exactly the other way around. We're trying the creativity first and then we're surprised that it doesn't work with the knowledge.
So is what you're describing right now the numeracy project that was introduced in 2000?
That is exactly right. And in fact, the New Zealand Initiative produced a big report in 2015 on the numeracy project. And just to remind the listeners, that was a project that cost the New Zealand government $70 million. And the idea was to change the way that mathematics is taught. So previously, you would have learned the basics. You would have learned the facts. You would have learned your times tables. In came the numeracy project. And the idea was to let the students experiment, give them different tools, let them experiment. How do I get to an outcome of a mathematical equation? Now, the thing is actually, that is an interesting way of doing math if you're mathematically gifted.
Yes.
If you're a mathematically gifted student, if you're a mathematically gifted teacher, and the combination, then that works quite well. The problem is if you're not so mathematically gifted, you would typically be better off just learning the times tables, finding some really tried and tested ways of solving your mathematical problems, and then moving on to the more interesting and more creative stuff. The numeracy project prescribed the other way around. So we spent $70 million in trying to reform teaching only to find out years later that it didn't work. But no government has yet had the guts to admit failure and say, no, we have to start again.
Very interesting stuff. Thank you so much for explaining that. It's Dr. Oliver Hartwich, New Zealand Initiative.